In the early 2000s, Brazil boasted two of the most sought-after teenagers in world football, in the shape of Diego and Robinho. The former would go on to have a stellar career with Werder Bremen, before an ill-fated move to Juventus ruined things for him, and the latter became yet another player who crumbled under the weight of expectations. At the age of 15, Brazil legend Pelé had already confirmed the young forward to be his successor. That was down to Robinho's skill on the pitch. The youngster was simply phenomenal and was destined for greatness. After leading Santos to the 2002 Brazilian Serie A title, Pelé's belief increased that Robinho was his successor indeed. Parallels were drawn between the two, and it made all the right sense initially, given the fact that Pelé also made a name for himself in the same club. During his time at Santos, Robinho helped himself to a few individual awards such as Bola de Prata, Bola de Ouro, and at just the age of 19, Robinho was regularly given chances to represent Brazil's national team. At this point, like many young Brazilian starlets, Robinho was snapped up by Real Madrid. Ramon Calderon, the club's president at the time, moved heaven and earth to sign a player whose trajectory was only upwards. Robinho arrived at the Santiago Bernabeu at a time when Los Blancos' Galacticos cycle was coming to an end. The youngster was brought in as the next big thing in the game and did start brightly before Fabio Capello started introducing a weekly snooze fest for the supporters. The Italian tactician wanted his players to be disciplined and conform to the standards that he set. Robinho, being the archetypical Brazilian player, needed to have flair in his game, and this flashiness was why he was dropped to the bench. Madrid won the league title and Robinho was confined to a few cameos here and there. The 2007-08 season was a promising one for the forward, since Capello was fired and German manager Bernd Schuster was brought on. Robinho would go on to play a crucial role as Madrid won La Liga. The youngster even finished inside the top 10 of both the Ballon d'Or and FIFA World Player of the Year award nominations. Based on that season, it was natural that big things were expected of the talented forward. Sadly though, politics at the club would intervene and ruin Robinho's morale and as a consequence his performances. In a bid to consolidate his standing during the elections, Calderon desperately tried to bring Cristiano Ronaldo from Manchester United. Bringing the Portuguese man to the Spanish capital would help Calderon stay on as the club's president. The Madrid Supremo did not want Robinho at the club, and the Brazilian was being used as bait to bring in Ronaldo. Seeing that he was being used as a pawn in the dirty politics at Real Madrid, Robinho decided that he wanted to leave. After handing in a transfer request, which was duly accepted, Robinho became part of a tussle between Chelsea and Manchester City. Luis Felipe Scolari wanted to sign his fellow countryman but failed to do so. Instead, Manchester City won the race. Robinho did not leave Madrid on a positive note either. Before departing, the player said this to the president who pushed him towards the exit door. "I do not want to stay. I would rather be a travelling salesman, sell cakes in the fair, than remain at this club." The moment he arrived in England, it was clear that Robinho had a lot of confidence and wanted to become the best. The forward was very clear in stating his desire to become the best in the world, win the World Cup, go back to Santos and guide them to a Copa Libertadores title. Sadly though, his first season in Manchester saw the club fail to seal a place in Europe. Robinho scored 14 goals in his first campaign in England, but missed the start of the second season due to an injury from which he struggled to recover. When Mark Hughes was sacked and Roberto Mancini was announced as the Welshman's replacement, it became clear that the Brazilian's time in England was over. The gifted forward suffered perhaps the biggest humiliation of his career after he was brought on and then substituted in the 2-0 defeat at the hands of Everton. The Brazilian would then be loaned back to former side Santos, where he would struggle for form and fitness. Eventually, however, Robinho was signed by AC Milan, where he would play alongside the likes of Zlatan Ibrahimovic and Thiago Silva. He scored a brace in the 37th game of the season that ensured the Rossoneri the Scudetto. The next season wasn't bad for the Lombardy Giants either, and they finished second. However, Robinho struggled with his form once again and managed only 6 goals in 28 Serie A outings. His stats didn't improve in the 2012-13 campaign, and the former Man City man would only score twice in the league. The 13-14 season would be the last time Robinho would play for Milan before returning to Santos for 2 seasons. At Santos, Robinho would show signs of drastic improvement and more maturity, but sadly, we were never able to see the player who had the world at his feet when he first arrived in Europe all those years ago. The skill was there, but the confidence in his own ability was nowhere to be seen. This was a player who'd burned out and knew that his time at the top was practically over. In July 2015, Robinho decided to sign a 6-month deal with Chinese Super League side Guangzhou Evergrande. The forward was expected to do well in China, but he managed only 3 goals in 10 outings, even though his team still won the league title. The Chinese outfit decided not to extend his contract, and Robinho decided to sign a 2-year deal with Atletico Mineiro in 2016. This turned out to be a very good move, as the Brazilian was the top scorer in Brazil with 25 goals. Sadly though, Robinho was not happy staying in Brazil and decided to leave Mineiro after 2 seasons in which he scored 39 goals in 109 matches. Turkish Super League side Sivasspor came calling in 2018 and Robinho signed another 2-year contract. Sadly though, a move to Turkey did not help the Brazilian reignite the flame in him, and he would leave for Istanbul Başakşehir after scoring only 12 goals in 2 years. For the Seleção, Robinho's career was the story of a player who promised a lot, yet delivered very little. At the 2010 World Cup in South Africa, Robinho was seen as the go-to guy for the national side. Playing alongside Luis Fabiano in attack, the forward didn't fare miserably, but wasn't inspiring either. Brazil eventually lost the quarter-final to the Netherlands, and for the next 2 years, Robinho would not be selected to play for the national side. Ahead of the 2014 World Cup in Brazil, Robinho was given a few chances to showcase his worth, but was eventually not included in the 25-man squad by Scolari. One has to say that Robinho's time with the national team came at a time when Brazil was also searching for its own identity. The team lacked that X factor to drive them towards success. Robinho was expected to be that person, but that never happened. However, there was no one else in the national team either who could ease off the pressure on the forward's shoulder. Despite making 100 appearances for the Seleção in his 14-year career, Robinho's time for the Samba nation is largely seen as a failure. Now 38, he's pretty much nearing the end of his time as a professional player. It's indeed sad that we were never able to witness the greatness he had in him. Circumstances, poor attitude, and politics truly had a massive impact on his career. And we can only imagine how different things could have been had Robinho been treated better by Real Madrid. At the time when he was being forced out of Madrid by Calderón, Robinho was at the peak of his powers and playing very well. Sadly though, it was Calderón's politics and willingness to sacrifice him for another star that saw Robinho pushed towards a point of no return.